And the variation in sign will be continuous. So for these two to be continuous, it plus a and minus a, because these are our boundaries. These are the boundaries where the potential change occur from 0 to V naught. So on these boundaries, they are supposed to be continuous. Now I know one thing, that V of x is actually even in nature, because it is symmetric on both sides. So the wave functions will also be symmetric as they are interacting with this potential. So we will have sine of minus x equals to plus minus psi of x. Now therefore we will have two solutions. When our potential is even, then we will have either even solutions, or we can have odd solutions. When psi minus x will be equal to plus psi x, then it will be an even solution, and when it will be psi minus x will be minus psi x, it will be an odd solution. And we can apply that this psi minus x from one side on the other side as well. So let me write that psi of x is equal to g e to the power minus kx when x is greater than a, and this is d and cos lx when x is between a and 0, means only this side, and this will be sine of minus x. So all these that we are taking are actually the even solutions. We first consider the even solutions. Now for the even solution, I am considering one side, and this is g e to the power minus kx for this region, the third region. When I come to this solution, then I see that in this solution I am having this the odd solution and this the even solution. So I will take only the even solution in this range. And then if the last solution will be even, then psi of x will be equal to psi minus of x. Otherwise, if it would be odd, which I am not considering at the moment, then here minus will come in. So I am only taking in the first region the solution when x is less than 0, means, but it is only the even solution. So I will have now to go only with the even solution, and will check that what will be the result of the boundary conditions on them. So let's say we apply the boundary conditions on them, and the very first boundary condition is that psi will be continuous on both sides of the boundary, and the boundary is x greater than a. So on x greater than a side will be the same for x less than a side. So I can write that the first boundary condition applies that psi is continuous. Psi is continuous on the boundary. And what is the boundary? The boundary is actually this one, that x is greater than A in X is less than A, this boundary, we will have to consider that psi is continuous. So this will become G e to the power minus kx is equal to 8 x equals a is equal a d cos lx in x equals a. So this implies that g e to the power minus ka is equal to d cos L A. And let's say this is our equation 1. I call from here 1, so this is equation 1. And similarly, when I will have the second boundary condition, and the second boundary condition is that d psi over dx is also continuous, on the boundary. So this is also continuous. When this is continuous, then I can write that the derivative of this one, so it will be minus kge minus ka minus ge minus ka at x equal to a, and this will be minus sine and l and d minus sine minus l and d sine of L A. So we are having the minus will cancel with minus. So G E minus K A is equal to L D sine this, and this is, let's say, equation 2 from here. Now if I divide equation 2 on 1, then divide equation 2 by 1. So what we will get, if I divide 2 is this one, this is g e minus k a is equal to l d sine l a, and this is divided by this one, the equation 1, which is g e minus k a, and here it will have minus k here, so k I forgot, so minus k here, this is k here, and this is g e minus k a, and this is d cos l a, d cos L A. Now there is some cancellation. G minus K will go with G minus K, and here D will go with D, and I can write that this implies that K is equal to L, and sine L A by cos L A will become tangent L A. Now this equation is actually relating our K and L with each other, and we know that K is equal, as we have supposed, to 2ME over H bar, and we have also supposed that L is equal to 2ME plus V naught square root by H bar. So now this equation is actually relating K key with L. So it is giving us the elevate energies for this geometry. This equation, which is K equals L tangent LA, is giving the elevate set of energies. So what are the energies that are elevate? We can now write this equation, and this equation we call is the we will change this equation into some other variables. Let's say we do a change of variables, some variables. Let me select that I define that Z is defined is equal to LA, and Z naught, which is a constant, is A over H bar and 2m V naught square root. So I have defined this one Z equal to LA and this, and I can now go back to this equation, and this equation will tell me the tangent. So for LA I can now write Z. So tangent Z is equal to K over L, because this L will come here, K over L. And in terms of Z and Z naught, I can prove that this thing, this tangent Z or this K over L, is equal to Z naught divided by Z squared minus 1 and square root. And this equation I call the transcendental equation. The transcendental equation, and I will solve this equation with the help of plotting. So we will find the solution of this equation in terms of plotting this equation. We will plot tangent Z, and we will plot Z naught by Z minus 1 and the square minus 1 square root, and wherever the two plots will be intersecting, those points will be actually the solution of this transcendental equation. So let me first prove that this tangent Z can be written like this. So let's start with this, that z naught square, let me write this thing, is I can write that k over l is equal to z naught square over z square minus 1 square root. I have written it like this. Now I can write that this is z naught square minus z square and square root, and this is divided by z square, so I can write this is z out of the square root. Now I know that z is equal to LA, so I can write this is LA and z naught square minus z square. And I can write that when this L is cancelling here with this L, so I can write that KA is equal to Z naught square minus Z square. So now put the value of Z naught square and Z square from here. z naught square is a square over h bar square and 2m v naught minus z square is l square a square. So z square is l square a square and l square is this one. So I can write a squared, and for l square I can write 2m e plus v naught divided by h bar square, because this square root will go and it will be h bar square, and this whole is inside a square root. Now I can see here that there is some cancellation, and the cancellation is 2m v naught a square by h square. 2m v naught by h square and here a square. So the v naught portion is actually cancelling. And we will get that this is minus a square 2m over h bar square and e. So Ka is equal to minus a square over h bar square and 2m e square root. So if I take a over h bar outside, then a over h bar means out of the square root, and minus 2m e, then I see that a is cancelling with a, and this goes that k is equal, k is then come out.